Hello guys, welcome to the EA Info. In this channel, we are going to discuss new technology, interesting things, and some life hacks that we can use in our lives. And today, we are going to look at the fastest growing techs these days. Can you guess what those are? And yes, you may get that right, it is augmented reality and virtual reality. In today's video, we are going to answer these questions. What are those? What are the differences between them? And why do they grow so fast? Let's start with augmented reality, or as we can call it, AR. It was first introduced to the world in 1968. Ivan Sutherland, an American computer scientist and internet pioneer, invented the head-mounted display that acted as a window into the virtual world. Give a thumbs up if you like augmented reality. One of the most popular technological trends today is augmented reality, AR, and as more smartphones and other devices that support AR become available globally, its popularity will only increase. With a digital augmentation placed over it, AR technology allowed us to view the world immediately in front of us, including the trees swinging in the park, dogs chasing balls, and children playing soccer. For example, most of you guys and girls are familiar with those filters and applications like Snapchat and Instagram, where you can put some digital effects on the physical environment. The most popular game where AR has been used is Pokemon Go, where you should find a Pokemon and place it into the sphere. Games aside, AR plays an important role these days. Google Maps uses it when we follow the route on the map. Have you used an AR app from IKEA before you made an online purchase? So you can see if it is going to fit in your place or if it is going to look good there. Did you watch the Soccer World Cup? Yes, AR is used there too. Mostly, it's used to draw lines on the field to illustrate and analyze plays. Even neurosurgeons sometimes use AR to project a 3D model of a brain to help them in surgeries. Okay, let's now move to virtual reality, which we know as VR. Using VR, we can explore and interact with a three-dimensional, computer-generated world to completely immerse you in the virtual world, giving the simulation a lifelike feel. You can use special goggles, also known as VR headsets. In addition to that, to interact with the virtual environment, you can use hand controls, gloves equipped with sensors, or the VR headset itself. A little bit of history now. The 1830s had seen the beginning of virtual reality technology. In Pygmalion Spectacles, a science fiction novel in which the main character appears to be wearing a pair of spectacles that transfer him to a fantastical realm, VR first appeared in 1935, however, and it quickly gained popularity. Since then, VR technology has seen several advancements, which led to the 2012 release of the Oculus Rift, which gave rise to modern VR as we know it. How does it work? Virtual worlds that users of VR headsets see and interact with are produced by the software. The virtual environment moves just like the actual world would when you look around with the VR headgear covering your eyes. Our brain is tricked into thinking that we are genuinely in the virtual world by the combination of these fake images and the VR headset sound. After only a short time in VR, this illusion can become quite strong and produce situations like individuals walking into walls because they don't realize they are in a virtual environment. Usually, we can use VR in many ways, such as virtual industrial tours, real estate virtual tours, playing games, hanging out with friends, and socializing. Who knows, it may be used for educational purposes also. Would you like to study in a virtual class? Leave a comment below about your thoughts on that. Now, we can move to the differences between those two. The primary difference between augmented reality, AR, and virtual reality, VR, is that whereas VR immerses users in a virtual environment, AR takes the existing real-world environment and overlays virtual information on top of it. AR inserts the user in a kind of mixed reality, whereas VR immerses them in a brand new virtual experience. The devices used to accomplish this are different, too. Virtual reality uses headsets to show users simulated visual and auditory information. Less constrained AR devices often include smartphones, eyewear, projections, and HUDs in automobiles. This is it for today. If you like this video, please hit that subscribe button, give us a thumbs up, and leave a comment. Let us know what you would like to see next on this channel.